took everything I had to not add a 666 like a baby. Yeah, I guess I have a real resentment against the archetype of a wallflower or something. Maybe it's because I was sort of a dysmorphic teenager, heroin chic, and it just really felt like, you know, you were supposed to be like this and really like waify and shy, and that was the pinnacle of desirability. And it's a tragic shame, obviously, that media encourages that. It just really means something to me to, you know, tell young girls that it's okay to be fully realized, and that you don't have to be ashamed if you have an opinion. We're entitled to a life too. You know, I make out okay vis-a-vis boyfriends and what have you. It hasn't seemed to really be a problem. So I'm here to tell the young girls that, yeah, you can seem like too much and still get some. I love the LGBTQ community. Why does it seem like the world is sectioned off in some way where there's even any sense of categorization? I mean, I'm never not gonna be in shock that people think they have a right to dictate who is or is not allowed to get married is one of the most insane things of all time. I can't believe that as a society we've decided that it's okay to say that people get to have an opinion on who gets to do what in this life or make people feel any type of way. But I'm a Cheerleader was a seminal moment for me that I realized the impact, I guess, of telling stories in a way where everybody got to feel reflected in some authentic way. I'm grateful for that. Also, I get to go to a lot of really cool pride parades and, you know, so that's a good time. Honey, I've never cared about one thing in my whole life, other than everything. I might be a little bit done with the past. I think I'm becoming something of a futurist, and it's devastating to think of it strictly as a dystopian landscape. I think I maintain some sort of willful ignorance around potential optimism of, could it be that it would ever be a little bit utopian? Is that possible? What's so crazy about Orange is the New Black is it's getting to be almost a decade ago, and it's you know, very moving that there's this lineage or this, I guess, a sisterhood in a way. I'm reluctant to use that word because it makes me think of things that are weird. I don't like it as a word. Maybe I don't love the binary of the whole discussion being about that, and yet in a show or a season that's so much about chosen family and chosen mothers or the way that sort of the nature of fate chooses your mothers and your family for you. It's quite moving to have such touchstones of that. As a college dropout, it's as close as I think what I would have to something. I imagine that maybe that's like what a sorority is like or something, your friends for life. To relax and recenter, I mostly like to ash in ice cream cones. Because I find that an ashtray is too convenient. So why not get a little ice cream and ash directly in there? Oh, look, there's some right now. So, you know, just think of this as an ashtray, and what do you do with an ashtray? You want to eat the ashtray, you know? Delicious. On Pee Wee's Playhouse, when I was a child, so proud of that show, I ate fake ice cream, and it was, tasted like chalk. But here we are, I've made it. And they now give me real ice cream whenever I go to set because they think I'm insane. I think I spaced out a little bit in there. I maybe had blacked out. I'm a blackout thinker, you should know.